So there's a couple of ways to actually start your Webex session. You can actually click on the link and that'll start it. If it does not open, the other way to do it is actually open up a tab, go back to this email, and you want to right-click and you want to copy link address. And then you can take your new tab and actually paste it in there and hit enter, and it'll take you to your Webex training session. So for students that have multiple days of training, you'll see here that you can receive an email that'll give you day one, day two, day three. In this case, it is the water, wastewater course, groundwater production. And what you'll do is you'll refer back to the original email, but for each day, you'll use that specific link. So you can go ahead and click on the hyperlink. And just like if you had one class, you'll enter your name and your email address, and then you'll join now. And here it states 8 a.m. April 21st, and gives you the presenters. And it's pretty straightforward. So on the next day, you go back to your original email, hit day two. And then on day three, you'll hit a different session. To join the session, you're going to go ahead and enter your name and the email address that you've been using to receive your Webex training. This is essentially what you'll be seeing once your Cisco Webex training starts. You'll see a pop-up. It says your presenter has started an integrated voice conference, and you do want to click yes on this. At this point, you'll be asked which speaker you want to use and which microphone you want to use, and you'll have a pull down for your different speakers and microphones if you do have several, and you want to make sure to use the correct one, and you'll hit OK on each. To make sure that you've actually chosen the right microphone, you'll see this bar right here at the bottom, and you'll see as you speak, like I'm speaking now, you'll see the actual range go up into the positive, and you know you've chosen the right microphone. Once you've done that, you can hit OK. Also keep in mind that if you have a video camera, you can choose that as well. Once you hit OK, you're going to see this pop-up for volume. You can see that there's a slider at the bottom and there's a slider at the top. You can also mute yourself using this pop-up, but later on we'll show you another way to do that. But it's very important for you to hear yourself and the instructor to hear you, and also very important to hear your instructor. So I went ahead and maxed these out, and that might be a good idea, but if later on you do want to change it, you'll actually go to audio and then integrated voice conference, and you're going to click on volume. And there you go. You got it again. So that is audio, integrated voice conference, volume, and you can work with your sliders right here. All right, we'd like to highlight this section right here. By default, this window will come up for participants, and this is essentially the way you're going to conduct the class. Since you are remote and online, you can chat with the instructor, and you can also control your video right here and your mic. Once it's turned red, that means it is turned off, and if it's clear, that means it's turned on again. I'd like to direct you to these icons right down here. This one right here is to raise your hand. You'll see that pop-up come up, and you'll click it and unclick it. And then this one is if the instructor asks you if you understand the course material, you'll click it, unclick it, and same for no, if you understand or do not understand. And this right here is to go slower, and that lets the instructor know that they might need to slow down. And this one is also to go faster. So if they need to speed up, you can do that as well. All right, next what we'll cover is actually chatting with the instructor. What you want to do is send to host. You'll see this pull down, and you want to make sure it's the host. And then you can click on this and you say, have a question, and make sure to hit send. Now you'll see it actually come up, TEEX participant to host, and this is private, only the host can see it. You have a question. You can also say, thank you, I understand, and that will send it as well. Here's another option with your chat window. You can actually close it completely and you'll just see what's being presented. If you want to go back into chat with participants, you'll open that. And then here is your chat button. So as you saw before, both of them are open. If you want to close that, close that. This is a really easy way to start chat and to chat with other participants. At some point, your instructor may present some material that was emailed to you, possibly in a PDF. And the best way to do this while you have one screen open is to actually minimize the window. And I just grab this other corner and just pull in. And then you can move this over and just resize it if you need to. And grab this corner, and then here's the course material, and you can open it up. So here you can see I have got my PDF open with course material laid out in one screen right here, one window, and I can minimize it or increase the size. And then I've got my instructor screen right over here, and you can just work with it depending on the size of your monitor. And you can just grab the corner and you can see I can minimize it or increase the size, and now I've got them next to each other. When your instructor actually starts presenting from a screen, you notice that you'll lose your chat window and your participant window, and it's really easy to get it back. You just hover on this blue icon right here and you'll see the pull down. And you can actually hit your chat and participant, and they are back. These are actually floating, and you can still be able to type, did I miss something? Helps if I actually type it in right. And you can hit send. And then you can also mute and unmute your mic. And if you're having problems hearing your instructor, you can use your audio, or if they're having issues with you, you can actually adjust it through here, right here, with these sliders. There is also one very large blue button called Return, and if you click on that, you'll see that that original window comes up with your chat and your participant panel. What you want to do is hit Return to Sharing, and then you'll be back into what your instructor is sharing. If you need to get back to your presentation materials or your course materials, what you want to do is go up right up to this corner right here, and you'll see Restore Down, and there you go. You can actually see, oh, there's my course material, and you can grab it and move it around as your instructor is presenting, and you can work with the size of the screen, and now they're right next to each other. And if you want to go full size again, the other way to do it is actually click down here on this icon, this Acrobat icon, and you can see you can actually float that around. So remember, these are windows on top of each other or next to each other. It just depends on what you want to do with the screen or that pop-up.